Hey, Richard, say hello to Kevin, our HERS Raider.
Hi, Kevin, how are you?
Good morning. It's a great day to be a HERS Raider.
Thanks for all your help on this project. Take us through, what is the HERS Rating?
The HERS Rating stands for Home Energy Rating System. It's a system that uses what's called an energy model that takes into account all of the attributes of the house.
Okay. What are the attributes?
The walls, the roof, the R value of the insulation, the efficiency of all your equipment, heating, cooling.
Yeah, everything that would go into the cost of operating that.
Everything goes into this spreadsheet, and the output is the HERS Rating.
Okay, so what are we seeing here?
The HERS Rating falls on a scale of zero upwards. A typical house built in the 70s and 80s might have a HERS Rating of 140. And a house built according to the 2006 energy code would have a HERS Rating of 100. In Massachusetts, the energy code says you have to get a HERS Rating of 52, which means the house uses 52% of the energy of the 2006 house.
Well, that's half of that, but what catches my eye is that it's gonna be what, almost two-thirds less than a typical home if we build into this system.
Yes.
So we gotta work hard to get to this point.
We do. I made some models up, and this is a mock-up of our existing roof system that we have now, which is 2x8 framing with fiberglass insulation, giving us an R value of 29.
That's our existing condition.
That's right.
Okay.
And normally we would do is just take out the fiberglass insulation and spray in a closed cell foam, giving us an R value of 49.
Okay, so that's pretty good. You get that almost double there. Sidewall similar?
Same thing. What we have here is a model of our sidewall conditions, 2x4 framing with fiberglass insulation, giving us an R value of 13. And same thing, we remove all the fiberglass in a renovation and then spray in closed cell foam, giving us an R value of a 21.
Would that get us to our 52?
In a typical house, it would make 52 within reach.
Okay.
Unfortunately, there are certain pieces of the house
okay. That
weigh the HERS Rating down.
Okay. And one of them is the brick facade that we have, and on the outside it shows as well as the inside.
Yeah.
Fortunately, 1 inch of foam in between them really works in our favor, giving us an R value of 7. Here's our biggest headache probably, is we have an existing concrete slab, no insulation under it, R value of 0.
Our 0 is pretty low.
It's pretty low.
All right, so that triggered a whole nether level of insulation, right?
It does, and this is a mock-up of our new roofing system. So same thing, our 2x8 framing, which would have our closed cell foam giving us an R value of 49, but then we took it a step higher and we put 2 layers of foam insulation. And the reason I want to do 2 layers of foam is I want to overlap the seams so nothing can really come through each sheet. So we're going to have an extra about 12 here,
yeah. Giving
us an R value of 60.
And this is great because, you know, people don't realize that the heat can still transfer right up here, up through the roof.
That's
right. This will break it.
That's right. And now our new framing addition is going to have a 2x6. Fill it with closed cell foam, but we're also going to add 1 inch of foam on the exterior of this, giving us an R value of 42.
So does that satisfy it?
It brings us close, but we're not quite there.
Really?
So here's the solution for the slab. This model here, this represents the foundation.
Gotcha.
And then we have our gravel on the ground.
Right.
So what we're going to do is take out the concrete slab.
You take all the slab, which you're not going to hate anyways because there was all that ductwork under there.
Got to run electrical, plumbing, ductwork, everything. Okay. So spray the closed cell foam right to the gravel.
Good.
About 2 inches or so, giving us an R value of 15.
Yeah.
This represents our concrete pour.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna have sleepers 16 inches on center with 2 inches of rigid foam in between that.
That's terrific.
And then our 3/4 sub flooring.
Like a little cooking recipe, Charlie.
It is. And then our radiant heat.
Radiant heat and the finished floor.
And then it finishes off with the floor.
So
and that will give us an R value of around 20.
That's a far cry from the R0 that was here. Does that get us there?
It brings us very close. Fortunately, we're doing the windows and the doors, so that puts us over the edge.
I gotta tell you though, I mean, it is a lot of industry. By the time you do all this and all that build up, I mean, what's the premium that's gonna be added to this project?
I'm guessing 25-30% at least.
To be energy efficient. And he can't get around it. It has to be to get a building permit, right? You had to get it.
That's right. The code compels you to get a 52.
And then I have to make one more phone call at the end. He has to come back and do one more blower test actually to show that we have the 52.
So it has to be nice to him right to the end?
We do.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project. So be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button to make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.